Today, I will show you how to build a very simple IP calculator in C Sharp in Visual Studio 2017. This is my IP calculator. What does it do? If you provide your IP address, suppose 192.168.1.2.1.34, and if you give your CID, suppose 24, and then press the calculator subnet, it will show you the subnet of your IP address. How I have done this, I will show you. I will show you the complete process from first to last, the designing and the logic behind this. Okay, so let's see how I have done this. First of all, you need to install your Visual Studio 2017 Community Edition, and you have to update everything. I'm using Windows 10. The version of my Windows is 1703, was built 16 to 32.1000. I have to mention that I'm using Windows 10 Insider Preview, so it doesn't matter, but you have to use the latest build. Okay, so first of all, you need a Visual Studio. I'm canceling this. At first, you have to create a new project. I should mention you before starting that if you have to know the basic idea about building Windows 10 apps. Okay, if you don't have any idea, you will just only understand, but you will not get the wide variety of details. I'll use C Sharp, Windows Universal, Landcap, and my app name should be IP Calculator. I'll do IP Calculator too, though I already have the calculator. I'm using a different color of IP Calculator. Landcap. And then press off. Now what you have to do, you have to provide the definition of your platform, target version, I mean, or Windows 10 Insider Preview or Windows 10 Creator Update. I will target for Creator Update. And minimum version, whatever you like. I always go for the latest version. Press off. Will take a while. It's taking time because I'm not using SSD hard disk. If you use SSD hard disk, it will be quick. First of all, I have to create a new class. My class name will be ipconfig. Whatever you want to name, you can name it. So ipconfig, I have to define a new class. This is IP address. Oops, sorry. IP address class, I have to define constructor of this class. I will use byte because the IP range is 0 to 255, so it's better to use byte. Now I have to create some variable IP address. First octet. That will stop here. Public static. So I will fix this letter in subnet. So what I have to do, create a bit decimal for easy purpose. So bit decimal is 5. For this I have watched a video for IP and subnet.
Hey guys, this is the video you guys been waiting for.
Sorry, extremely sorry. I'm having problem with this game player. I have to check the bit decimal information. So
people were wondering how I came about that. All right, how do I get that? They give you the normal one.
128, 192. Okay, let's do this. How long this area? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There is 8. B decimal completed. Get the IP and CID, okay. And I have to end this IP address with this bit decimal. So if the CID, it will depend on CID. So I have to provide the condition for CID. If CID is less than 8 or equal to 8. So I have to build the IP address for end operation. So this is the IP address, and I have to end with this IP address. So what will I end? I will end on new IP address with this CID. Is the CID 8? Okay. Is 128. Let me think fast. Okay. I think I got it. Number, okay. If CID is 2, then what? If CID is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever, it will be 2. 0 is 0, 1 is 1, 2, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 0, 1, 2, 3. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, great, 8. Yeah. Cool. Then, why would say the dizzy? Dizzy. Bell. I mean the bell. Okay. So, I will study the parts. If CIDR is greater than 8 and CIDR is less than and equal to 16, and what do we give to power? So I can get this mean decimal value for the second of it. IP address 255 second power 0 power 0. Now is the property request. So now I have to specify the condition here. It's better than less than or equal to 20. Then I have to specify for 16 and power. So this is the third IP. This is 7 and this is 255. Then or equal to 24 plus 8 or equal to 24. This is going to be 4. The subnet. Now what else I will do? I will create default. Else. This is the default for set case. Idea 000. Now what I have to do is to end this. I got the mask and got the IP address, and then I have to end this. So I need to provide the byte. Dev.parseNumPy and byte.parseNumPy. What I have missed? Why they're so rare? Let's say cannot convert integers to byte. Okay, great. I will go to the byte anyway, but I do because I wanted to see what we put without specifying explicitly byte. Long, so I have to step down. Now it's looking great, nice. Now I have to return the subnet. Return sub. This is sub. Great. Excellent. So next thing what I have to do is to create the layout, design, etc. I have to go to the main page. In this page, wait, it's loading. So this is the grid. Okay, let it load. I have to, within this while, I'm gonna define some drawing for it. Draw definition. Definition. How many rows? I don't know. Maybe the field. Shit. Let's do some pagos, okay? Five. And height will be complicated. Let's give it some columns. Okay. Three dot one. So pass in pass row I will provide the title. Let's see my calculator again. So yes, first row is IP calculator, second row calculate subnet. It's really too narrow. I cannot work. I think I have to. I want to split it. Wait, please. Wait a while. I'll fix it. First of all, I have to write the calculator. So, first row is IP calculator, second row is subnet. So, yep. So, let's do this block. I don't want to provide the name because I'm going to do it with this just normally. It has the text for being I have to read dot column span. How many columns do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, 4. Column span 4. Horizontal element. Center. I have to define some margin for the top. So top is 0 dot 20 dot 0 dot 0. Let's see. Now it's looking great. Yeah. I have to see the middle, okay? So I have to space some margin for all this as well. Let's do this. Margin 0. Let this be 15, 0.0. We dot balance pen 4. Why didn't you pull it the horizontal element? Seriously? Seriously? No, it's okay, wait. So, then in the third row, I have to specify the what? The IP user interface, okay. Okay. So I'll tap to this text block. Input your IP, input CID. So what I'm gonna do is in the first column, I have to do this. First column, wait. In the first column, then second column is gonna go down this. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Sorry, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I've got a 5 column. Let's do this. It's not extra. Text block again. Text block text input your IP input your IP columns here, so I don't have to specify the column explicitly. Let's default column 0. I mean, first column. So I have to specify the margin, okay. Vertical or no, horizontal. So, horizontal element. Right. Once you get the margin. Margin. How can I specify margin? That would be a margin for this one. And 0.0. I think so. Excellent. It looks great. Yeah. And text block again. This is this row, height of this row. Height of this row would be how many? Star, what is star? Let me think. I think one star is good. It's fine. Yeah, fine. IP, CID here. So horizontal alignment, right. And I think I don't need to specify the margin because it's not really secure. Center issue. Okay. I don't want to provide the margin anymore. Text block, that text block. Okay. Right, so I don't need to provide the margin. I want to go to the center. And also, I'm not going to provide the margin for this as well. Center. Should be the combo box. First of all, I'm gonna run this app. Yep, let's do run. It will take a while. You can use this in your phone, in your computer, everywhere. Okay. Yes, nice, great, excellent. Now I have to provide the combo box in here. I got some margin issue. Yeah, let's decide to paste. Fantastic. Nice, excellent. Wonderful job. Let's do this. Now, let's provide the combo box. Combo box. First of all, I wanna listen some. Wait. Combo box. Combo box. Wow, combo box. Combo box name. It has a name. So I have to interact with this directly. So I have to provide a name for this. Okay. So what should be the name of this first object? IP. So first of all, I have just defined the combox. 2, 3, 4. The second, is this the third? What is the fourth? So where this should be placed, let's define them. Dot row wire. Dot two. Yes, correct. So all that should be read dot two. Column now. I need a more column. How can I prove it? I have to define one more column. Great, nice, excellent. So I'm using the phone preview. What I got. Calculator. Oh, with the now I have the problem with this one. Yes. So let's define column span. Five. Column span. Five. Now they're off. So CID, it has the CID. I have also have the combo box for this one. The CID. 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 I also have a combo. Should be calling in 1 minute. Yes. The name should be CID. CID. Yes, nice. Now what I have to do is to insert the payload for this combo box. So I have to insert the rails at the IP range is 0 to 255. So I don't want to go explicitly write them down. The combo box item to 255. No, I'm not gonna do this. I'm gonna do this in a dynamic way and a programmatic way. So what I have to do is to go in here, and it has a load event. So I have to create an event for this page that is loaded. Okay. So load it. New event. Page load. So let's go this event. So page loaded, I have to specify some functions for this method. What should be first of all, I have to create a for integer. I is equal to 0. I is less than 256. Okay. I plus plus. In this problem, I have to define some task. So the first combo box was IP passed. Okay, IP passed. Oops, sorry. First, I have to the combo box item. Combo box item is new. Combo box item. A.content is I dot to string. The content stores string value, so I have to convert this integer to string. Dot items. Dot add. Now I want to see if this is on and not. Let's run one for one time. If everything off or not, let's see. time calculator. Excellent. Fantastic. 255 from 0. Great. And this is also great. 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 Excellent. Fantastic. So I have to define the CI. So let's do this. So what should be the C idea? Do you have any idea what should I have to do for this? I have to define again a new folder for this. What's happening, man? Less than R3. I don't wanna use R3. I wanna use 32. Yes, and then I have to provide this equal sign. Okay. So now I have to use this comp box. Comp box item is equal to new comp box item. What I have to do is now I have to provide a new calculate sum. Wait a second. What I have done to this button, huh? I cannot see. See the problem with this button? Yeah. So this is the IP calculator. You see the button? So I have to define input. So I have to define the calculator. No. I think I had to define it with the row. Column span, yes, column span. So I have to define the column span. We don't want to do it. Column span too. Nice. Now let's see it. What? Man, seriously? Okay, wait. Okay, whatever. I don't wanna waste time in this button anymore. So I have to define a text block for the result text block. Name result. R-E-S-U-L-T result text block. Result text block, nice. The text block we dot row by row we dot column two column two. Spain. Wait a second. What I have done to my this one. See the thing, this is the rule. I have got this physics. I really forgot about thing that I just provide the new grid for this one. This is the different grid and this one is the root grid. Okay. I have done a mistake. I'm really sorry for this. I'm really sorry. Really sorry. Too much sorry. So I have to define the grid for this one. Wait a second, I'm gonna fix this thing. Please wait. It has three row definition, first row pointing the IP calculator title, the subtitle, second row pointing the subtitle. So margin is from the top and this margin is from top to bottom. And then this grid will point to the rest of them. So the column is perfect and the row is different. Help me with this. So one is for one is for one is to line dot row zero. Wait a second, man. What I'm just doing? A second, where is my bot? This is the bot that you're talking about. I left two columns for this one. The most hardest part in this designing the layout is really sucks. Okay, I'll just some text for this so I can see what I'm doing on the how it goes up. How does it goes up? This button is go to column 0. Now it's up. Great. Excellent. Fantastic. Pardon. This is going to be now. Left. Wait a second. Wait a second. I think I have to provide a stack now. Find this button and even click it. Information from So 0, 1, 2, 3. 0, 1, 2, 3. What is the far left? Far left. Nice and excellent. I'm successful. Great. Wow. So guys, thanks for watching. This is very simple IP calculator. Okay. Very simple IP calculator. Oh, I have to eliminate these things. So what I have to do is just to add the text. Now everything is fine and excellent. So guys, this is it. Thanks for watching. If you like this, just press the like button. And hope you guys will like this and you have learned something. See you next time. Goodbye.